Peter Higgins!
Don't stop. We could just have 5 minutes of you guys clapping. My night would be a piece of piss. I tell you what, these lights are hot. I'm gonna walk off looking Latin. So, Great Britain, it's been a bit divided the last couple of weeks, hasn't it? The old leave the EU debate. I remember in the run up to the vote, I was out with a mate. We're on the lash, having a few bevvies, having a chat, talking about women and work and sport. And I asked him, what do you think about Brexit? And he said, to be honest, mate, I don't know that much about him yet. Is he a defender? These people actually walk amongst us. But you know, it is tough times for a lot of people. A lot of people, it's tough times. Not everyone, obviously. You know who has got it easy nowadays? Paedophiles. It's true. Years ago, in your day, back in your day, years ago they had to invest, buy sweets and stuff like that. Nowadays they just pull up in their car and say to kids, do you want to charge your iPhone? Fancy some apple juice? I know, it's not right, is it? It's not right. Kids shouldn't have iPhones. Do any of you ever remember the show Crime Watch? Yeah. It was a great show, though. It was great for me, seeing all my old mates. It was like logging onto Facebook. I was sat there watching the telly. I tried to add a friend on teletext. It was great, great show. But, you know, I was thinking back to years ago, because tonight isn't my first time performing. I remember once I went on a family holiday and my dad took me into the talent show. So I was there doing karaoke. My no-nonsense, northern working class dad was sat in the audience watching with his pint of bitter and a scowl. And I'm on stage and I'm singing I Am the One and Only by Chesney Hawkes, doing all the actions, belting it out. And at the end, I finished, I climbed off stage, very excited. I ran over to my dad and I said, what do you think, Dad? Of course, at the time, I didn't realise I was talking to the working man, Simon Cowell. He took a swig of his beer, he looked me in the eye, and he said, the way you sing, son, you might be discovered. Hopefully under someone's patio. Thanks, Dad. Don't sugarcoat it, will you? But you know, I wanted to talk a bit about dating tonight, because the old Netflix and chill has become a bit of a popular thing nowadays. And I've got to be honest, I'm not a big fan. You are? I'm not a big fan. I mean, I don't know about you lot, but I just think if a bloke wants to get on with a girl, inviting her round to his to watch an episode of Making a Murderer isn't going to do the trick. But I recently went on a date. I went out for a meal with a girl, and I had visions of a nice romantic meal. Fine wine and delicious food. The restaurant had other ideas. Their special was the dressed Dorset crab. It looked like it was drowning. There was so much oil on the plate, America wanted to fucking invade it. But I was unperturbed, so I tried to rescue the night. Recover the mood, so to speak. Cheers, lad. So I tried to rescue the night, so we went to watch a film. A Walk Among the Tombstones. Romantic. It's a Liam Neeson film, and he has to find a girl who's been kidnapped. It's exactly like all his other films. He's done Taken 1, Taken 2, Taken 3. He's taken the piss. But you know what? After karaoke gate, I didn't give up art. I mean, I obviously left the singing behind, but I decided on stand-up comedy. And I remember thinking after my first show, I was a little bit disappointed at the end because I didn't get a standing ovation. It's true. And that's the last time I performed for the Paralympics. That's it for me, folks. Thank you very much. Bye, mate.